We got all this to cut out, make new ones, new pieces of plywood, work our way back here and make these all new again. And we'll just drop the vinyl all the way. Yeah, so here's what you do when you need a workbench. We take one of the pieces of plywood that we made for the overhead in the galley, and I clamped it around here to the base of the bed, and this is what I'm going to use as my workbench to sand these pieces. And yeah, it'll work. Back to another exciting and thrill-filled adventure with DIY Nautical Dream. Okay, maybe that was a little over the top. Anyways, we'll go ahead and get our next video started.
Hi guys.
Hey everybody.
So welcome back. This week episode, we are gonna start replacing aft cabin overhead panels, and then we're gonna start installing newly rebuilt port lights.
Yep.
And then husband's gonna make a template for aft cabin teak panels.
Yep.
So stay tuned, guys. Let's get on this week project.
Yeah, we got a lot on our plate today and it's making her nervous. So we're just gonna get to work. We're gonna quit talking about it. Like you guys always say, quit talking about it and let's get some action going. So that's what we're going to do this time. We'll see you at the end of the day and let you know how far we got.
All right, let's do it.
Let's go.
Still. All right,
we're after it. These tools caught my eye and seemed interesting. Thought we'd give them a try out and see if they would help us along our processes. Well, we bought some new tools this week. This is going to be used for cutting vinyl. It has a sharp metal wheel that pops down. And you can use it kind of like a pizza cutter to cut vinyl. Also, I think we're going to be able to use it to cut fiberglass, should we need to do that in the future. And then got a nice pair of vinyl pliers. And we use these for pulling the vinyl and stretching the vinyl back into place before we staple it back up. So that these would have really came in handy last weekend. But anyways, those are going to work nice. Then we have these... These are like contour finders, like what you see on TV. And you just push them into the wall or whatever the corner is you're trying to make, the shape, and it'll duplicate it. And then you just trace that outline out. So we got a, looks like about a 10 inch one, and then like a, looks like a 5 or 6 inch one, so, or something like that. Anyways, so yeah, pretty cool. Extra tools, can't hurt, make the job easier.
Now we have a fine collection of teak plugs and even some mahogany plugs. This should hold us over for a little bit.
All right, there were some people wondering what we were going to do about these holes here once we drill the bungs out, the teak bungs out. And, well, I ordered some of these off of eBay. And there's 100 in each bag. And these are 3/8 inch thick.
And let's see. So what I plan on doing is, if you notice, there's a little bit of grain to it, to some of these. And yeah, I would just turn it to kind of line it up with the grain on the wood here. And then I would just tap this in there, tap it in nice and tight, and get it to where it's flush. And then once it's flush, you can just take a really sharp chisel or some kind of like a maybe a razor knife or something, and then just cut it off a little bit proud, so it's a little bit high above the surface here. And then you can just sand it smooth to match the surface, and then go ahead and just varnish this area here or stain it or whatever you're going to have, and that should take care of it.
We won't be installing these teak plugs anytime soon. Even though we may mount the teak trim, we won't install the plugs until we're completely done in the area, because we don't want to keep drilling and removing these each time we have to pull the trim back down. So, because we don't know if we're going to be doing wiring or whatever behind there, so we want to wait until we're finally done. Then we'll install the plugs and trim them, sand them, varnish them. But I'm also hoping to go ahead and sand these. That one, this one, get these sanded to bare wood, maybe get a slap a coat of varnish on them before we leave today. Workbench here. Was a bed, but now it's a workbench. Crazy. I have a feeling the aft cabin is slowly slipping into a workshop for the boat. I don't know if we're going to be able to continue to use this space as a workshop and try to refit the aft cabin at the same time, but the two forces are competing each other, so.
Well, I need a working surface to sand on, and so I just took a piece of the plywood we have cut out, made up for the ceiling, and clamped it here to the bed, and we're going to go ahead and use this as our sanding surface. So, hey, you know, got to improvise, right? So, anyways, it'll work out, and that's what we're going to use. We'll sand these pieces up right here, get all these sanded up, and then hopefully get some varnish on them before I can head out of here today. That's the plan.
If you ever watch Sail Life, you might remember Mad saying, "Glorious sanding." Well, here we go. We're going to do some glorious sanding of our own. Let's get started.
All right, let's see how this goes.
Seems like it goes a lot faster when I put it in fast forward mode on the video editing program. But when I'm doing it for real back there sanding, it does not go this fast. So maybe we can look for that fast forward button on the sander and time lapse this. But anyways, we're putting in a pretty good amount of effort getting that old varnish off of there and trying to sand this down to where it's back to bare wood. The reason why we're putting the effort into it is because we want to get the old color out of there from the previous owner's varnish. There's multiple layers on there, and we want to try and get everything to match the best we can. And so that's really, the color that's on there is definitely not going to match what we have to apply on our new teak panels. And we don't want them to clash that much. So we're going to try and strip it the best we can. I know there's probably an easier way, but we haven't learned it yet, so we're going to do it the hard way. So after a fair amount of time sanding these three pieces, we have them stripped back to bare wood pretty well. And we'll go ahead and get these ready to apply the new varnish on there, and hopefully everything will match up. Okay, I think we had enough fun sanding for a while. Let's transition back to the galley overhead structure project. That one's always good for some fun times.
But I think the good sign is we don't have any water dripping. No water dripping on the inside, because we fixed those leaks up in there. And now it's all nice and dry. So we're happy with that. I could go ahead and install this, epoxy this in place, but I don't know. But then once we get those epoxied in place, we got all this to cut out, make new ones, new pieces of plywood, work our way back here, and make these all new again. And we'll just drop the vinyl. I decided I'm gonna paint up here. No real purpose for it, other than the fact that I just wanna have it painted. And I just figure we're gonna cover this area up anyways, and nobody will ever see it, but I'm hoping that it'll just, I don't know. I just thought I would do it. I have some old paint and there's a good use for it. So we'll go ahead and paint this whole area in as I close it back up with the new pieces of plywood. And then, I don't know. I just thought I would do it. So anyways, it's a good, nice, good clean surface. And if we ever have to get in here in the future, then hopefully it'll give us a good idea where the trouble's at, if there's anything going on in here. Nice clean surface. If there's water running or something, hopefully it'll leave tracks, and then we'll be able to see where it's coming from. Anyways, like I said, no real purpose for it other than that we have some old paint, and I thought a good place to put it. So that's it.
Now that we have a little bit of paint on the surface inside that galley overhead area, I'm starting to like that. I think that's a good idea. I know it takes time and a lot of people won't think it's useful, but like I said, if we have to get in here and do any kind of troubleshooting or anything later on down the road, it'll be a really good way to see where it's coming from or what's going on in here. And it just looks fresh. It looks new. I like it. It's not going to slow us down that much. We're going to go ahead and keep doing it. Okay, while we wait for that paint to dry in that area, we're going to go ahead and transition back to the aft cabin, and we're going to see if we can get one of these newly rebuilt port lights installed. That would be a really big step for us. We're going to be really happy if we can go ahead and pull that off today. Let's see how we do. Hey baby, would you be able to check to see if this port light's lined up good from the outside? Just take a look at the cutout and how it's sitting in there and make sure the edges are sitting good. Everything's all nice, even gaps. If you could take a picture so I can see what it looks like, please.
Of course, Captain.
Thanks, baby. So based on the pictures that baby took while she was outside, it looks like it's good enough and it's sitting in the cutout the way we want it to. We're going to go ahead and start locating these holes and getting this thing mounted. This port light cutout looks like it's pretty bad. Actually, it looks like at the factory they mislocated the hole or cut it too big and tried to glue the piece back into place, or some previous owner did that. And it just looks hideous, this crack. And so what we did is on the inside, we strengthened it up with some fiberglass cloth. And on the outside, we're going to take the Dremel tool and we're going to cut that crack-looking piece. And we're going to put some thickened epoxy in there and we'll fair it all in. And eventually we'll put gel coat over it, so we won't ever see it again. But for right now, it looks pretty rough. Okay, so it's time to start locating some holes here. But the first thing we're trying to do is we got to use these clamps to kind of clamp the plywood and the port light frame a little bit closer to the back part of the cabin top, the fiberglass section. Otherwise, our screws aren't going to reach. And so it's just kind of forcing the plywood to bend and conform to the round part of the aft bulkhead here. And so we got to be careful. We don't want to go too tight because we don't want to make the wood bend farther than it needs to. But we got to get close enough so that at least the screws will start when we get the holes located. A delicate balance. Too far and we've gone the wrong way and something's going to break, and not far enough, our screws won't start. They won't be long enough. Well, there it is. We have our first port light mounted. Took a little bit of struggling, a little bit of figuring it out. We haven't mounted one of these before, so it was the first time doing it. Big learning curve on these, but we got it figured out and it looks pretty good. Stepping back, definitely looks nice. It looks like it's new from here. Anyways, so that's good. We're pretty happy about that, and we're ready to move on and see about getting some other ones in. But first, we got to seal it and caulk it from the outside so that no moisture is going to get in there. That's going to be a messy job. All right, so one thing we forgot to do is to tape off around the rim of the port light housing, and so that we would have prevented our seal from getting all over the place. But we're gonna have to clean that up. That's going to be a little bit more of a mess. That'll be a learning curve that we're going to make sure we don't do that on any of the others. But anyways, it's caulked in there and it's sealed really well, so now we just need it to rain to make sure that it doesn't leak. But I think we did a good job. We got more than enough seal on there, I'm sure. All right, since we only had one port light to install, we're going to go ahead and transition from installing port lights to fitting the overhead panels that go up over the top of the sleeping area in the aft cabin here. And this is to replace that white wobbly looking plastic that was up there. And we're going to try and get this door skin to fit really nice. And if that works out well, then we'll transfer that onto a teak panel and try and make that fit. But for right now, we're going to try our luck at getting this thing to fit better than what was on there before. Hang in there. Let's see how this turns out. Okay, so this is a view if you're laying down in the bed looking up at the ceiling, and you can see the door skin here. I have it just temporarily sitting in place. And we're trying to go with a gap-free fit all the way around. And so this has some really odd angles and contours and shapes to it. So it's not an easy, it's not like sanding something into a square shape. This has got some really odd compound angles and corners to it. So we're going to take it slow and get a good fit going on this. And if, like I said, if we have any good luck with it, we'll transfer it onto a teak plywood and we'll make something really beautiful go back here. It's important when we're trying to make a gap-free fit back here to put a little upward pressure on it as it would sit if it was mounted in place. Not so much that it deforms it or warps the material or anything like that, but just enough to so it's kind of a snug fit and everything's contacting really well. And that will show us the areas that are touching and possibly leaving gaps in other areas. So that's what I'm doing here with my hand. I'm just lightly pushing up on it to check. In this image here, you can see where I'm trying to gauge how much actually goes underneath this piece of trim. And it looks like it's about almost a quarter inch. So I have to make sure that we have that amount going underneath there as well. So it'll kind of hold it in place like a tab. And it actually works out pretty good doing it that way. In this image here, you can see where I added a little extra edge margin on this piece of door skin. And that was when I was outlining it with that white piece of plastic. I added a little bit of extra just to give us a little bit of room to make a better fit. And you can see it was a good thing I did that, because otherwise we would have been short on, we would have had a big gap there to work with. This is a pretty good example in this picture here of all the complex edges and interfaces that are along the side of this panel and the angles and everything like that. And if you look real close, you can see there are no gaps on this at all. So this is a really good fit. To get a fit like this requires a lot of time, a lot of patience, a lot of careful, slow hand sanding, and continuously lifting this panel on and off, checking, rechecking, because we don't want to go too far, because if you go too far on one side, one angle, or one corner, it's going to throw it off somewhere else. So it just took a lot of patience, but you can see we're starting to get a really good, desirable fit here. Here you can see it was handy. We actually reinstalled the opposite side white plastic panel and used that as kind of a slot to slide the door skin piece that we're trying to fit. We'd use that to slide it in underneath that white plastic panel and it would hold it into place for us. So that was one less place I had to try and use my hand to hold something in place. It worked out really, really well in our advantage. And so then I could kind of just set my hand off of it a little bit and it wouldn't fall down. So I could kind of look back and make sure all the edges are good. And we ended up with a really nice fitting panel here. At this point, we're getting really close. We still have a few gaps we're trying to minimize, but otherwise we're really happy with how it's looking so far. It's coming along good. For all the compound corners, curves, and edges, it's looking like it's gonna be a good fit. All right, so been here fitting this panel here in the aft cabin over the bed area, and I'm very happy with the results from when I took off the template from this the other side over here. Yeah, so it's gonna look really good. Go home and now I know what to do when I make the permanent piece out of teak. So we're gonna add an inch on this edge here, because I want it to come to center. I want it to meet the center on this piece here of trim, because when these two pieces are joined together, sorry about the finger in the camera there, but when these two pieces are joined together, I want to put a piece of teak going all the way down the joint here. So we'll conceal that with the teak. And then I'm not sure what we're going to do here, because this is a pretty good fit. But if for some reason it doesn't turn out as nice as we want, we could always put some trim here, or some kind of black vinyl edge bulb or something in here that would seal this gap better. But I think it's going to be fine. And then, man, this turned out really good along through here, because the other piece had a gap. Wasn't even close. So this turned out really good. And then on down
all the way down there. You can't see because of the light, but anyways, that turned out really good.
All in all, very happy. So I'm going to go ahead and make it out of the real stuff next time. I'll make it out of teak. This here is just very cheap plywood, but gonna start with something. So I took this pattern off of the old white plastic vinyl, that whatever this stuff is here doesn't belong in a boat if you ask me. And this is gonna be real wood. I'm gonna make this out of teak also, because I don't like it, not at all. Anyways, but that's later. Right now, we just want to get this made, get it installed, and then we'll take a pattern off of this. Once this side's good, we're going to take a pattern off of this, and we'll make it. We'll do the same thing with that side. Anyways, just good progress. Pretty happy with it.
So, if we learn one thing out of this whole process, is it takes time to do the job right. If whoever put that white plastic up there would have took the time to do the job right, and made it look nice, and the gaps weren't all crummy on it, we might have even thought about leaving it on there just because it wasn't something we wanted to mess with. But the more we looked at it, the more both of us didn't like it, and we're going to be laying down here in bed looking up at this, and I just thought, I don't like it, she doesn't like it, so we're going to do something about it. And this is what we decided to come up with. This is going to be really nice. I can't imagine what it's going to look like made out of teak, but we're going to soon find out. We decided to go forward, and we're going to put the teak panels in there, and looks like we're going to be able to get a good fit. So let's see how it turns out. So as we're getting ready to cut this panel out of teak now, you can see the door skin template that we made, and that's our final fit. You can see all the crazy corners, edges, and there's curves and straight angles and all kinds of things going on here with this panel. It took a long time for us to get this to fit the way we wanted it to, the way we're actually happy with it. So now we're going to cut it out of the teak, and we want to make sure that we have the grain facing the right direction before we make our cut, so that it's facing the right direction when it's in the boat and we're looking at it, and it's not, grain's not going off at an angle or something, because that'd be frustrating. So here's one of our first teak panels that we cut out using that template that we spent all that time hand fitting, and it's got one coat of varnish on it already. We put the varnish on there to protect that veneer because it's really thin, but what do you guys think? Is this going to be a thing of beauty or what? This is going to be on the overhead right over the top of our bed when we're laying down looking up. That's what we're going to see. That's really beautiful. That turned out really good. We're both kind of surprised at how well it turned out. Very excited to see what this is going to come together looking like in the end, but so far we're pretty excited. The teak plywood we're using is single-sided veneer. And it's 1/4 inch thick, and we bought it from a local hardwood supply store here locally, and we get it for about $125 a sheet. He usually gets a sheet that's got a dinged up edge on it or whatever and gives me a discount, so we usually wait till he has a couple extra sheets that are damaged, and then we'll pick them up, because we really don't need it to be perfect on all four edges. So that's what we do. We just kind of wait and time it just right, and it's worked out well for us so far. So in the very back on the sides, they have these vertical white plastic panels, and we're going to do the same thing. So you can see on the blue tape here, I've already written down the measurements of the gaps and where we want to add extra edge margin on there. We'll take that home, we'll transfer that onto a piece of door skin, and if we're feeling really brave, we might skip the door skin and go straight to teak plywood, but haven't quite decided yet. But we'll transfer that information on there, add some extra edge margin, maintain the shape, make it a little bit bigger all the way around, and try and get that piece to fit in there perfectly. And we'll shoot for high quality like always and see what it turns out looking like. Okay, well, we had to do it. We had to see what this looks like. So we're gonna go ahead and show it now. And so we have the first teak piece of paneling in place on the overhead, looking back, looking up over the bed. What do you think? It's kind of looking good, huh? Does it look better than that white plastic or what? Keep in mind, we're shooting for a thing of beauty status here. That's all we want. We don't want to accept anything less than that. If you have any ideas to help improve upon how this looks, please let us know before we finalize it. Okay, so I went ahead and fit in the new teak panel and marked the areas already where I need to take a little bit off, so it's going to sit a little bit better here. I just went a little bit
too long on the back side, the part where it slides underneath this teak here. And so I'm going to go ahead and sand from about here over. And then here, all the way over to here a little bit. And that'll allow all this to go aft just a tiny bit. And then it's going to go ahead and it's going to close that up. And that'll be a nice fit. But man, look at the difference.
Wow.
Nice, totally nice, beautiful fit along here. All those neat little edges there. So, and this will all attach. There's actually a wood behind here that it's going to attach to. So it's gonna sit up here really nice. And yep, it's going to hold itself in place really good. So what do you think? What do you like better, the white or the teak? I'm going to say the teak. And we also have new light fixtures that are brass housings. And they actually have a teak colored glass lampshade on them. And we'll mount one over here as well. And they have a nice USB plug-in as well. So it's going to be very cool. And then the next project's going to be... I already measured my gaps on here, what I need to do. And I'm going to make a new one of these out of... I'll make this out of teak as well. So can you imagine that? That's going to look really... really nice. We'll have the grain going vertical. Yep, I think we're gonna go vertical on the grain. And yeah, it's gonna look really nice. Eventually we're gonna be I don't know if I can save these or not. I'll give it a try. I'll sand them down, but it looks like right here, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to save that or not, but I can give it a try. We'll see what happens. But anyways, yeah, man, sure looks nice, huh? All right.
Just wanted to highlight on this little vertical panel, we're going to use this plastic panel to make a template out of. You can see on the blue tape the dimensions I added on there on how much extra we need to add on there. We're not adding a whole lot, so we got to be careful not to add too much or it won't even fit in there, and we won't even have a good starting point to start sanding on. We'll have to sand a lot just in the very beginning. Here you can see the teak panel sitting in there. Underneath the white vinyl plastic or whatever you call it on the other side. Big contrast there in what kind of quality we're looking at here. The white stuff just never really made it. I don't know why they even went with that, but either way, the teak's looking really good. Just kind of step back and take a look at that. The grain's facing forward like we want it to. It's not off to an angle or anything like that. It looks like something we can go with. In this view here, we wanted to kind of show the side fit on this because it has such kind of odd angles and contours on it that we tried really hard to get a good fit there, because on the white plastic piece, it had really bad gaps over there and just looked really bad. So we put a lot of extra detail, attention to detail on these edges and getting these to fit really well. And you can see how it's going forward, that forward long piece is going forward. That's a good gap, good fit all the way, very even, steady, making nice contact all the way. So we wanted to step back and take a look and see what the difference is. And so here you can see the white vinyl panel in place. We already know what that looks like, but then we're gonna step back and see what the two of them look like side by side here. And there you go, there's your white vinyl panel and there is the teak panel. Now that's a big difference right there in looks. So that's kind of our vision of what we're trying to do with the aft cabin, especially the over the bed type area there. And I think it's going to turn out really well. It's already starting to really make progress and show us what we're looking for as far as the vision. And tell us what you think. What do you like it or not? I mean, we're going with it either way, but just nice to kind of hear other people's opinions. We really liked all the teak and the Formosas and the CTs that we were looking at. And so we're really trying to go for that, have that look in our aft cabin on this boat as well. Just really, we both really like teak, so it's not going to hurt us to have a little extra teak in the aft cabin. So while we were working on the boat, Dad decided he wanted to stop by and check on our progress. So he came out and took a look at it and seemed like he approved of how we were doing. And we'll try to wow him with it later when it's all put together back there. But yeah, he's impressed. He's also pretty happy that we ended up getting the 52. He was worried we were going to get a boat that was too small, like a 49 or a 50 or a 51, something like that. He thought we should go a little bit bigger. So here he's holding out his hands, showing us that it measures up to his expectations. When we were boat shopping, Dad came along with us on a couple of the boat tours, and I had to remind him that the bigger the boat, the bigger the mortgage payment as well.
This here, we got that fitted. That's really nice. I'm very happy with that. So that was the whole reason we wanted to come up here. Next time we'll make a new one of those. And I would like to countersink these fasteners today before I leave, if I have time. I want to countersink these so they sit flush, because right now they're raised up a little bit. Could do that. And can't really install this permanently yet because, well, we're fitting that panel under there. And then also, I need to sand these pieces, the trim pieces that go back in here. I can't install those. I won't be able to put the screws in, especially on this piece that goes up here. I won't be able to put the screws in once this is permanently mounted. So I don't want to just run this in and out a whole bunch of times. But we're getting there. You know what? It was worth the trip up here just to get this panel fitted. So if nothing else happens today, that was a big success. But
all right. So honey, tell me what we have, what we get.
Oh,
where are we at?
How far we struggled?
What's our status?
How far we struggled today?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we started working in the aft cabin, and this is a section over the bed area that has those white vinyl panels on there that just seriously annoy me and you. And we have those garbage lights back there. We just finally decided we're going to do something about this. So we pulled those down. We took them home, used them as templates to make the... we're going to make door skin panels to fit those in first, and then if we can get those fitted good, we'll put the teak panels in there. And so that's what we started working on today, and we made some pretty good progress on that. And also, we started to install the aft cabin two very far aft bulkhead port lights. And note to self, we don't want to over tighten those down so tight that we break the panel again. So we're really cautious with that and got those in. Looks really nice. And yeah, that aft cabin's really starting to come along. It's starting to look like a thing of beauty. And we're really just, we're proud of what we're doing. We're getting really good at it. And you did the varnish. The varnish turned out really nice back there. And with those new rebuilt port lights and everything starting to be installed, man, it's looking good. You guys, man, I don't know what you guys think, but if you see it in person, how it looked when we bought the boat and how it's starting to look now, it's really motivating. So we're looking forward to making more progress. We're happy with the skills that we're learning along the way. We're gonna take that, what we know and what we've learned, and apply it to the rest of the project on the whole boat. And this thing's gonna really start looking sharp. So stay tuned. We really hope you're patient with us along the way. We're really trying to make some good progress and also try to do this channel better and improve our videos and our storytelling and everything else along the way. So hang with us. Please be patient. We're really trying hard to do better.
All right. So thanks for watching, guys.
Yep. Thanks for watching.
Stay tuned. And if you are not subscribed yet, please subscribe down below.
Ding. You know the button that says subscribe? Hit that for us, please. We really appreciate it.
And then we'll see you next time.
Yep. Stay tuned. We'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. We hope you have a wonderful day. See ya.
Now there's a nice looking shell. I'd keep that one.
And what's that?
My idea. Oh, we got a boat coming. It's this guy. Nice. Dang. 5 engines on the back.
Boat.
That was sweet.